ఈజ్ ఆఫ్ డూయింగ్ బిజినెస్ లో తెలుగు రాష్ట్రాలు టాప్ ప్లేస్ లో నిలిచాయి. వ్యాపార అనుకూలతలో తెలంగాణ రెండో స్థానంలో, ఏపీ మూడో స్థానంలో ఉన్నాయి. కేంద్ర ప్రభుత్వము, ప్రపంచ బ్యాంక్ కలిసి ఈ ర్యాంకుల్ని ప్రకటించాయి.
It includes about 15 different changes to how state governments and UT governments approach businesses, including, as we discussed, the risk-based inspections, but also how you provide information on the availability of industrial land and how you deal with labor inspections, labor registers, and a wide range of other policy changes. It looks at whether the states and union territories have established commercial courts, if they've been resourced with the right number of judges. It earns 1 point, no scores assigned for a no, and NAs are deducted from the number of applicable reforms on which the implementation score is based, and that is calculated as per the formula shown there. So if you look at evaluation, and you saw some of these numbers, and I just wanted to delve into them very quickly, we've seen that over the 3 years that this exercise has been in place, we've seen an increasing amount of interest from states in actually implementing the reform actions. In 3 years, we've seen about this number about triple. And in addition, as you saw, the average implementation across the country has also doubled almost, from 32% when we first started out 4 years ago, 3 years ago, sorry, up to 60% today. It's important to note that over time, the BRAP itself has evolved. As we've seen, it started with 285 and now it's moved on to 372. So the actual, so what this does is put in context the fact that the growth in average implementation is actually.
ఢిల్లీలో సులభతర వాణిజ్యం ర్యాంకులను ప్రకటిస్తున్నారు. ఆ కార్యక్రమాన్ని ఇప్పుడు లైవ్ లో చూద్దాం.
లాస్ట్ ఇయర్ ది ఇనిషియేటివ్ ఆఫ్ ద డిఐపిపి విచ్ ఎనేబుల్డ్ us to partner త్రిపుర అండ్ సిమిలర్లీ ది అదర్ స్టేట్స్ ఇట్ హస్ ఆల్సో బికమ్ కొలాబరేటివ్ ఫెడరలిజం ఆల్సో I really thank the officials also on behalf of all the states of the DIPP and the World Bank, particularly the respected Secretary Sir, Additional Secretary Sir and Joint Secretary Sir, who were very much involved in various stages in accepting our feedback and giving their feedback, which helped us in eventual implementation of the various reforms. And finally, I would like to also thank DIPP for selecting Telangana for this honors job of partnering or mentoring the state of Tripura, because we feel that it is a recognition of the efforts put in by the states who are partnering, as well as it's more importantly an opportunity for us to share also whatever we might have learned in the whole process with other states, because after all life is not about just competition and ranking, but it is also about taking everybody together. So we had a detailed meeting with the state of Tripura officials, and then we identified what are the real requirements which the state of Tripura requires. For doing this, officials from the state of Telangana went on two occasions to the state of Tripura, because we felt that about 22 departments are involved. For the officials of Tripura to come, all 22 departments, it may be more difficult. It would be rather easier if from Telangana a group of officers could go there and who are closely involved with all the departments in Telangana while implementing this whole exercise and share the experiences and try to give some kind of a perspective which might help the state of Tripura to achieve further their reform systems. So as a part of this whole exercise, we zeroed in on about 5 broad areas which we felt that state of Tripura needs to really move on. So one of which is the single window system, because this is the key kind of a reform. All the reforms are linked to this single window system because all the approvals are through this system. Then second is the central inspection system, which was again a new reform for the year 2017 and 2018. And as part of this inspection, the 3 connected reforms also. One is the risk categorization of the industries, how you categorize them as low risk, medium risk and the high risk, and then conduct of the joint inspections which are random and the computerized inspections which are there. And thirdly, how to lessen the role of the regulatory inspectors by way of self-certification scheme for the low risk industries and third party inspection for the medium risk industries. So broadly, we focused on these five and tried to build the capacities of the various teams which were involved there. Similarly, we created awareness on four existing processes which were there in Telangana, namely the fire no objection certificate, secondly the e-stamps or the assessment and the payment of the stamp duty, thirdly the filing of the tax returns for the various departments, whether it is the GST or whether it is the transport department or the other departments concerned, then identification of the green category industry. We shared the information which were the focus area of Telangana for the current year, that is the 2017, the online land allocation system in the various industrial parks, how they are being allocated, the online single window system for grant of the construction permits with the auto DCR feature, etc., the registration under the Interstate Migrant Workmen Act under the labor laws, similarly the approval for the boiler manufacturer, boiler erector, and the central inspection system. We helped them in identifying the system provider also who could implement the application software for a single window system and the central inspection framework. We also helped them in creation of the awareness on the B2G feedback. Namely, there were three critical aspects in this. One was to get the grievances, second was to get the online feedback, and third was also to reach out to the businesses by way of seminars, workshops, what my friend from Jharkhand mentioned, and also by conduct of some kind of a online survey also when they take the services which are involved. So I would like to compliment the state of Telangana, because from our observations what we felt that maybe because they were late starters in this whole exercise, the level of awareness about the various reforms what was not as comparable to the advanced states in as far as the ease of doing business reform action plan is concerned, and there was a certain kind of lack of coordination among the various departments, which is again a very key factor. There was this readiness to undergo the various reforms which are required so as to be able to improve the ranking, which we felt that during a visit there was a coordinated meeting under the chairmanship of the Principal Secretary Industries of Tripura, which was conducted on the first day, in which the broad perspective was created, and then we had one-to-one with each department, what each department needs to do. Willingness to learn from the best practices. So there were some impediments were there. Of course, they were in an election year, so they could not go at full speed. And from about 67 reforms which were approved for the 2016 year, this year they got 99 reforms approved. And but for the this election process, which slowed down all the other concerned departments also, they would have easily crossed about 150 or so. I am sure that in the coming days they will be doing it, sir. And we would be quite happy and glad to continue this partnership with them. Once again, sir, I would like to thank the DIPP for giving us this opportunity, and should the DIPP consider us again for sharing our practices with the other states, we would be more than happy to do so. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Respected Dais, ladies and gentlemen. Sir, I would like to sincerely appreciate DIPP as well as thanks to DIPP for allotting us Telangana state as a mentor state. We have learned a lot, and it is a fact and a correct statement that whatever Commissioner Industry sir has told just now, that we had two workshops with the Telangana state, wherein the officials from Telangana state came and handholding support was given. In fact, best practices were shared, and one-to-one interaction was much